The war was over and the boys were planning for a fall. The cabaret was quiet now except for the drilling in the wall. The curfew had been lifted and the gambling wheel shut down. Anyone with any sense had already left town. He was standing in the doorway looking like the Jack of Hearts. He moved across the mirrored room, set it up for everyone, he said. And everyone commenced to do what they were doing before he turned their heads. And he walked up to a stranger and he asked him with a grin, "Would you kindly tell me, friend, what time the show begins?" And he moved into the corner, face down like the Jack of Hearts. Backstage, the girls were playing. Five cards stood by the stairs. Lily had two queens. She was hoping for a third to match her pair. Outside, the streets were filling up. The windows opened wide. A gentle breeze was blowing. You could feel it from inside. Lily called another bit. Andrew was the Jack of Hearts. Big Jim was no one's fool, he owned the town's only diamond mine. He made his usual entrance, looking so dandy and so fine. With his bodyguards and silver cane and every hair in place, he took whatever he wanted to and he laid it all to waste. But his bodyguards and silver cane were no match for the Jack of Hearts. I know I've seen that face somewhere, Big Jim was thinking to himself. Maybe down in Mexico, a picture up on somebody's shelf. But then the crowd began to stamp their feet and the house lights did dim. And in the darkness of the room there was only Jim and him. Staring at the butterfly just drew the Jack of Hearts. Was a princess, she was fair-skinned and precious as a child. She did whatever she had to do, she had that sudden flash every time she smiled. She'd come away from a broken home, had lots of strange affairs with men in every walk of life, which took her everywhere. But she never met anyone quite like the Jack of Hearts. Judge came in, unnoticed, and was being winding down. The drilling in the wall kept up, but no one seemed to pay it any mind. It was known all around that Lily had Jim's ring, and nothing would ever come between Lily and the king. No, nothing ever would, except maybe the Jack of Hearts. Mary started drinking hard and seeing her reflection in the night. She was tired of the attention, tired of playing the role of Big Jim's wife. She had done a lot of bad things, even once tried suicide. Was looking to do just one good deed before she died. She was gazing to the future, riding on the Jack of Hearts. No one knows the circumstance, but they say that it happened pretty quick. The door to the dressing room burst open and a cold revolver clicked. And Big Jim was standing there, you couldn't say surprised. Rosemary right beside him, steady in her eyes. She was with Big Jim, but she was leaning to the Jack of Hearts. Two doors down, the boys finally made it through the wall and cleaned out the bank safe. It said that they got off with quite a haul. In the darkness by the riverbed, they waited on the ground for one more member who had a business back in town. But they couldn't go no further without the Jack of Hearts. The next day was hanging day, sky was overcast and black. Big Tim was covered up, killed by a penknife in the back. And Rosemary on the gallows, she didn't even blink. The hanging judge was sober, he hadn't had any drinks. The only person on the scene missing was the Jack of Hearts. The cabaret was empty now, the sign said closed for repair. Lily had already taken all of the dye out of her hair. She was thinking about her father, who she very rarely saw. Thinking about Rosemary and thinking about the law. But most of all, she was thinking about the Jack of Hearts.